Halo has come a really, really long way since its inception. The series started out as a Mac-exclusive title. It eventually turned into a first-person shooter on the Xbox and the PC that became one of the first true video game blockbusters. It was on top of the world immediately after its initial launch, and that's part of the reason it's kind of sad to see where it ended up. Ever since Bungie left the franchise, things have kind of went downhill. The Master Chief Collection was a disaster, Halo 4 and 5 were extremely disappointing, and then Halo Infinite, despite its solid foundation, may have been the final nail in the coffin. The campaign, the core gameplay of Infinite, they're honestly really good, but the serious lack of content and abundance of technical issues and broken promises, well, it's led to many remaining Halo fans about to jump ship. And I understand. Welcome to the channel, everybody. Chaos here. Can Halo be saved by a Halo Battle Royale? It's coming, and it looks like it's coming for Warzone 2. Today, we're going to go over everything we know about it, the leaks, the rumors, and I want to know what you guys think. Stick around for the entire video so you do not miss anything. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get into it. Now, it's hard to believe that Halo Infinite was actually supposed to launch a full year before it actually did, but at the end of the day, it's been on the market since late 2021, and it still does not have a lot of features that were promised from the initial reveal. What should have been Halo's big comeback quickly turned into Halo's final demise. But what if I told you guys they've got one more bullet? They've got one more Hail Mary in the tank. 343 Industries has been quietly coordinating a new Halo multiplayer experience that may be a couple years too late on the VR craze, but could be Microsoft's last-ditch attempt to put Halo back in the spotlight. And I've got a huge amount of intel about it. Like I said, a Halo Battle Royale is 100% in development. Today, we're going to go over all the details. Now, thanks to a Twitter user named Bathrobe Spartan, it's a good one, a number of Battle Royale screenshots have made their way into the wild. A number of new details have snuck out as well. According to everything I've read, the new BR will have a traditional format where there's a pregame, you load into your drop pod, you blast into a map, and yes, you can control your drop pod. Now, unlike other Battle Royale games, you will actually start the match with a weapon, and there will be teams as well. Bathrobe Spartan is apparently a data miner and was able to pull a bunch of information directly from the game code itself, which allowed us to see absolute proof that the game exists. And these details are true, although it leaves some of the previously leaked aspects in question. Now, originally, we believed that the game would kind of be this PvPvE experience. It would allow you to fight off Covenant forces, take over locations on the map in order to establish a base of sorts, and better prepare for coming battles with other players. While this hasn't been 100% confirmed, I actually think these leaks verify those rumors, as dropping into the map with a loadout would make sense if the Covenant are wandering around. I mean, you'll need something to fight them off. You would. Now, according to the leaks, the Halo Battle Royale is going to launch with Season 4 of Halo Infinite's content, meaning it should come out sometime around summer, spring, mid-2023, assuming nothing gets pushed back again. But now that you know all those details, let's get into the actual implications of this, because I think a Halo BR in mid-2023 could be the wrong move for Microsoft and 343. Now, first of all, Halo Infinite is not in the best place right now. Neither is the Halo IP in general. If the early days of Infinite's multiplayer proved anything, it was that the classic Halo multiplayer formula is all we really need to enjoy ourselves. You guys remember back when Infinite's multiplayer dropped? Everybody was playing it. 343 Industries have finally figured out how to make a crowd-pleasing Halo multiplayer, but the game itself, it's been such a complete mess that hardly anybody is populating the servers despite the fun factor. Now, the progression system at launch, it was a joke. It almost felt like you were being punished for playing the game you wanted to. A few updates have been made, but it's still not great, and especially compared to other multiplayer shooters on the market. On top of all that, there was a ton of missing content. 343 decided to slowly drip feed back to everybody, and people, they don't have the patience for it anymore. Gamers don't. I mean, I don't blame them. Halo 4 and 5 drove tons of people away from the Halo franchise, and 343 promised us that Infinite was going to be the one that made everything right. So why didn't it happen? Why didn't it have all the content from previous games at launch? And why are you drip feeding the missing content back instead of just giving it when it was promised? Ever since Infinite launch, there's been a very frustrating lack of urgency from 343 to fix the mistakes, and that has led to a classic case of too little, too late. Now, Halo Infinite in its current state is a decent game, but it's no secret that the gaming world just doesn't have patience like that anymore. Despite fantastic gameplay and extremely fun combat, Halo Infinite was kind of the poster child for bad live service strategies. And when content from the base game like campaign co-op started getting canceled without warning, that was the final straw. Halo Infinite is currently outside the top 20 most played games on Xbox Live, and it's not faring much better on the PC, where it reportedly has less than 5,000 concurrent players at any given moment. To put that into perspective, Modern Warfare 2 is killing it on both Xbox and PC. The Xbox Live charts have Modern Warfare 2 as the number one most played game on the platform, and according to Steam charts, there's over 130,000 PC players on the servers at any given time. Now, Halo Infinite isn't just dead, it's buried. It's completely destroyed, and the competition is not about to let it get back up. But some of you are probably thinking, a Halo BR? It wouldn't be competing with Modern Warfare 2 because Modern Warfare 2 isn't a BR. Well, let's talk about that because Modern Warfare 2, obviously, is getting its own BR. I mean, it's a little indie title called Warzone 2, and it's literally about to launch. Now, regardless of how you feel about the first Warzone, you can't deny it was a monumental success. A free-to-play Call of Duty game that not only captured the spirit of the franchise, but it was also able to take over one of the most popular game genres in the world at that time. Yes, it had its ups and downs. So while the last year or so hasn't been anything amazing, it's still one of the most played games in the world, boasts millions of players logging in every single day across console and PC. The leaks currently state Halo Infinite's Battle Royale mode is going to come mid-2023. And sure, Modern Warfare 2 may have slowed down by then, but Warzone 2 will probably just be hitting its stride. And if you think a sizable chunk of Warzone's community is going to jump ship to play Halo, I don't think so. Personally, I think the Halo BR is going to be pretty solid. I don't think it'll be amazing or anything, but I think at the very worst, Halo BR will probably be a 7 out of 10. But even if it's a 10 out of 10, and it's the best BR game ever made, it still has extremely stiff competition from Warzone 2 to the point I don't think it can win. First of all, there's a simple fact that Halo is going to miss out on the PlayStation player pool, which is significantly larger than Xbox's right now. The PC may technically have more players than both consoles put together, but when it comes to who's playing the big blockbuster AAA games, it's mainly the two consoles that are driving forces, and when Halo is missing out on one of them, it's going to suffer. It's definitely going to suffer in the battle against Call of Duty. Second of all, Halo's public reputation, it's bad. I mean, 343 have effectively pushed the majority of the community away from Halo Infinite, and those people aren't going to be super eager to come back just for a BR game. If anything, I think the launch of a Halo BR is going to do even more damage to the Halo community, because Halo Infinite, it's still experiencing many issues. If 343 decides to launch a Halo BR before fixing the issues of Infinite, the community is going to be, they're going to be pissed. Think about it. Halo Infinite launches 2021. Laundry list of problems. 2 years later, they release a Battle Royale mode instead of fixing all those problems. Do you think the community is going to be happy about that? Probably not. But perhaps the biggest thing that's going to keep Modern Warfare 2 and Warzone on top of Halo throughout 2023 is the game integration. Warzone 2 and Modern Warfare 2 are connected as an ecosystem. They support each other and they get their players to play together. It's currently unclear if the Halo BR is going to launch as part of Infinite or some kind of distinct spinoff. But the game will 10% be heavily associated with Halo Infinite, feature identical gameplay similar to how Modern Warfare 2 and Warzone 2 share gameplay. The main difference is Warzone players are going to want to play Modern Warfare 2 and vice versa. The same will not be said about Halo Infinite and BR. The community has been loud and clear on the fact they don't want a Battle Royale mode, so the core Halo community is not going to populate those servers. That means Microsoft and 343 are going to have to rely on non-Halo players to populate the BR servers, but you know what that means. That means the Halo BR player base is not going to spend any time playing Infinite, meaning the core Halo game is actually not going to benefit from a Halo BR. Meanwhile, Warzone 2 and Modern Warfare 2, they're going to keep on supporting each other thanks to the weapon integration, shared battle pass, similar gameplay loop. If you like Call of Duty's core gameplay, you'll like Warzone as well, and vice versa. But Halo's core gameplay loop, it's so different from a Battle Royale, I don't know if there's going to be much rollover. The core BR community aren't going to flock to the main Halo multiplayer, and the Halo's core community, they didn't want a BR in the first place. And if you want evidence to prove that people aren't going to flock to Halo Infinite's multiplayer, all you have to do is look at the player charts. The game has been out for almost a year. It's struggling to maintain any kind of relevance against the competition. Again, this first-party Microsoft game, it's not breaking the top 20 most played games on Microsoft's game console. A Halo BR is not only wanted by the core audience, but it's going to be ripped apart by the competition. Apex Legends, Warzone, Fortnite, bigger communities, bigger successes, and I don't know. Maybe they'll use this as evidence that the Halo IP needs to be restructured or rebooted. Now, it's kind of impressive that in this world of reboots and remakes that Microsoft has stood its ground and continued to make Halo sequels. I mean, they could have very easily rebooted the entire universe, pulled a fresh start, but they continued the existing timeline. I respect that. But with the failure of Halo Infinite, the guaranteed, not guaranteed, but likely failure of VR, I think Microsoft may actually start thinking about a full reset. I mean, they're doing that to Fable and Forza, so why not Halo? I'm not saying I want them to completely reboot Halo, but if you're Microsoft in this position, what do? The Halo franchise has collapsed, and from their perspective, reboots and remakes are a quick way to get people paying attention again. At this point, reboot it, start it over. It's painful watching the classic Halo timeline get crapped on over and over again. Just put it out of its misery, and we start over. So while this video started out as Halo VR leaks, it ended up with me asking Microsoft to just give Halo a rest until you figure out what to do with it and have a commitment with a 100% vision. Infinite's troubled production cycle is visible, and I think it's time to let it go. So you guys, let me know what you think. Are you going to be playing a Halo VR? Because trust me, it's coming, and I'll see you guys soon.